Hi guys, it's CFC Attacks 97 here, and this is Match Attacks episode 3 of series 2. So as promised, I'm doing a question and answer video, and if you look down to the bottom of the screen down here, you'll see the person's name here, and then the question they've asked along here, and I'll be answer it on the actual screen. So here's the first question. I think my favourite type of curry would be chicken tikka biryani. I quite like chicken tikka, but I quite like experimenting with different curries. But I like some of the side dishes, like sagaloo and the pineapple one. And I quite like the bread, the coconut bread, peshwari I think that's called. I'm not too sure, but I quite like curry. Chicken tikka biryani is my favourite though. So yeah, I'd probably have to say that. My best card collection that I've collected would probably have to be Shootouts 2003, purely because I completed it. I quite enjoyed collecting that because that was when football cards first launched in around the UK. They were quite a big hit, obviously not as good as Match Attacks, but they were quite a big hit, and I completed that season as well as the following seasons and the predecessing season. So yep, I was quite happy with completing that. And that was my favourite one. So yeah, Shootouts 2003. The best pull I got in a packet would have to be either Vidic Limited Edition or Van Persie Limited Edition for Extra. They're both half 10-11, but Van Persie's 10-11 Extra. I got Vidic. I bought 3 packets for some fun, and managed to get Vidic. Or it possibly could have been Rooney 101 in 10-11. Seeing as I only did buy 10 packs, and he's one in like 100 packs or something. I think it's a bit rarer than that. So yep, it's probably the Rooney 100 Club from 10-11, Vidic Limited Edition from 10-11, or the Van Persie Limited Edition from 10-11 Extra. If I could be any player in the world, I'd probably have to be a goalkeeper, because I'm a goalkeeper myself. But I'd probably be somebody who's played for England, so David James, Joe Hart, or someone big in the world like Iker Casillas, or Casillas. He's done quite well, I'd quite like to be him, or Manuel Neuer, the German goalie, I'm quite a big fan of him. So I wouldn't actually be a footballer, I'd be a goalkeeper, because obviously I'm a goalkeeper as well. So yep, I'd probably have to go with someone who plays for England, or Iker Casillas, or Manuel Neuer. So yeah, either one of them. My favourite video on YouTube, I quite like some of the fail compilations, they're quite funny, I quite enjoy them, I quite enjoy watching them, but if it had to do with Match Attacks, I quite enjoy watching Master of Match Attacks' videos, but also like watching Mario Kam 13's videos, but I quite enjoy watching Mark 12 Haran's videos, they're quite good. But some of the episodes are really, really awesome. But if it comes out to Match Attacks, I'd probably have to pick Master of Match Attacks for the most enjoyment in the videos. But if it came all over YouTube, I'd probably have to pick the fail compilations because they make me laugh. That's quite why I enjoy them. So if I have to pick them, would I give out collections if I worked for Topps? I would absolutely love to, but they'd probably have some sort of ban on where you can't give out cards unless they're paid for, probably something like that. So if I own tops, I'd give out collections and rare cards to people, yeah, but if I only worked for them, obviously I wouldn't be able to. But it's quite a good question there. No, I do not like WWE. I completely hate it. I do not like wrestling. My best birthday or Christmas, well, when I'm on my 8th birthday, I completed the 2003 Shootouts because I sent away for Thierry Henry, the quite rare card, and yep, I got him in the post on my birthday, which is funny enough. So lucky, yeah. So that was quite an enjoyable birthday. But my best Christmas, probably obviously all Christmases are good because the family comes down, but my best Christmas to do with Match Attacks, probably just this one just gone because I got the 910 box and a bag which wasn't in the best condition, so I sent it back and I got a good one through the mail which was on my movie. So that's probably my best Christmas. On my 8th birthday would be my best birthday I've had, but obviously they've all been absolutely fantastic. So I'd like to say thanks to my family for giving me great birthdays and great Christmases and a really good time. So yep, probably my 8th birthday, which was a real good one. My first Matchbox card was limited edition Giovanni when I bought this tin, and then I was a lot younger, so I threw the tin away. And the cards. bit of a big blunder, but I've got it all back now, including Giovanni. So, yep, I've got them all back. So, my first Matchbox card was Giovanni limited edition. My ratings would be quite high because I'd quite like to flatter myself, but I'd probably give myself, as being a 100 club, I quite like the whole limited edition, so that would be my card status. But my scores, I think I'd probably have to give 100 in goal or defence, but obviously goalkeepers can't come above 5 apparently. I think, I don't know, I'm not too sure, but I'd probably just give myself 6 or 7 for attack, but if you can't come over 5 then I'd give myself a 5. Obviously because it's the highest, but yep, 100 in defence and 5 in attack. I do get to go away quite a lot, seeing as I do play football for Arsenal Youth, but I think there's a lot of places we've been, Spain, Holland, Belgium, Mallorca, I've been to quite a few places, but including Ireland, I think that's probably the best one we've been on because we actually won the tournament away there, but the best holiday I had was probably in Spain with my family. So yeah, I've got some mail here, and I'm going to open it now. I've opened the parcel, but I haven't seen what's inside. And it's from Dreams, the bed specialist, but obviously it isn't. But anyway, it all folds out, and oh, they're in there. Okay, so as you've guessed, you've probably seen who I've got. It says here, there's a note, here's your Gareth Bale 100 Club and some other cards. Can you send me my Rio Ferdinand 100 Club and custom pack? My address is on the back. Obviously, I'm not going to show you the address, but I'll see what's inside here. So he sent me Bale 100 Club, which I needed. Galas star signing from Matchbox 10-11, and Gerardo Torrado star player from the England Matchbox series, or World Stars, I'm not too sure. But the main card I wanted was Gareth Bale 100 Club. So I've got him now, which is really awesome. He'll be going in my binder. I'll be showing you at the end of the episode. So that's the card I wanted, but he did include some bonus. And, yep, I will send you your stuff. And funny enough, it is right here. Jerkster 1993, thanks for the mail. I haven't put a stamp on it yet, but I will be sending this out. So thanks for the mail and thanks for trading. So now I'm going to update my 10-11 extra binder. I'll be placing the Gareth Bale 100 Club in there. I'm going to skip straight to the Man of the Matches because, as you all know, I've completed the base set. So yeah, to the Man of the Matches, and I got more the other day, but it's still on my want list. There's still someone there, but there's the space for Gareth Bale. So here's the Gareth Bale card, the one you saw earlier in the episode. So now I'm going to take him out of the plastic sleeve I've been keeping him in, place him into the binder. So, there it is, it's in. So, it looks pretty good in the binder, I should think. There it is in there. So, I do not need Gareth Bale 100 Club now, he's now off the list. However, any trades that you do have of Gareth Bale, I will accept because I'd quite like to get him in trade. I'm getting one more from the England fan one. So obviously I'm expecting that mail, so I look forward to getting that. But anyone else with any with the Frank Lampard limited edition, please PM me and I'll give you a good trade, which will be Robin Van Persie plus more if you'd like it. But yep, I'm doing quite well with the set. Not too far to go now. Hopefully I'll complete it by the swap and play tour. But there's Gareth Bale in the binder, so but I'm able to shut that binder now, and not long ago till I complete the set. So I very, very happily ticked Gareth Bale 100 Club off my want list. But now I'm going to bring you some awesome information on the Swap and Tour event. As we all know, it's coming closer and closer. It's on the 18th of April, which is a Monday, just to let you all know. I'm really, really excited. I'm going myself, and in here I have my swap and tour pack. So what I get in here is the leaflet explaining how long to go. So this is from the 1st of April, which is depending on when this is uploaded, but this was filmed on Thursday night and it might not be uploaded till Friday morning. However, there is 17 days to go until the event, which isn't very long at all for obvious reasons. But what I've also made is the Match Tax Swap and Tour event ticket. It's got my logo there, the Match Tax Live logo there. Match Tax Swap and Play Tour event. Admission free. The trading is £3. Ipswich Stadium, Monday the 18th of April 2011. On here it has the pitch layout and the stadium layout. I've been to the Ipswich before on a number of occasions. I've actually played there myself. And the Premier League logo there and the bar scanner there. So there's the ticket that I've made for the event. And here's the little leaflet explaining how long to go. There'll be a new one of these every episode until we actually go to the event. So that'll be really, really epic. So yep, there's them too. And I hope you like the ticket I've made. Anyone wants them, I can make them. I'll probably will trade them for something, but they're not worth that much. But PM me for your offers. But yeah, there's a fake ticket I've made, and there is the sort of like a mini calendar sort of thing, and it's in the swap and play pack. And this pack will be getting bigger and bigger as time moves on. So yeah, that's in there. So now to the last part of the episode. So just to leave you with something, I think I found a error card in 10.11, and so here it is. It's Bakary Sagna, Arsenal. This just looks like a regular card. Nothing wrong on the back, and nothing wrong with this picture. No facial expressions. Nothing wrong with the name, I don't think. No, there isn't. But the reason why I think this might be an error card is actually bigger than your average card. This bit here, there's a lot of white here, and about normal on there, but due to a lot of white on there, you'll see when I put these together that, I don't know if you can see the crease there or not, but I'll prove to you, these are lined up absolutely perfectly, as you can see now. Okay, and there's actually still a big crease there, if you notice there. There's still a big difference, so I don't know if that's an actual error or not, I'm not too sure, but it's actually bigger than your average card, which you could probably see that roughly about there. It's a little bit bigger height-wise as well. So I just thought I'd leave you with that, I thought that was pretty cool. And thank you Nigel de Jong for helping me with my experiment, and thanks Bakary Sagna. So that'll go on my error card set, along with the Petrov captain that I got from 1232 Tevez, so I'd like to say thanks to him as well. So, thanks for watching this video. Please comment, rate, and subscribe.